We are now going to Khar Dung La, one of the highest motorable road in the world. Now here, La in local language means pass. So actually name of pass is Khar Dung. Many times we called it wrongly as Khar Dung La Pass. Now this is Karakorum range. We are calling this as Trans-Himalayan range also. So this is Karakorum range or Trans-Himalayan range, where we are carrying out this recording in month of August. And that's why you'll find that road is completely dry. No traces of snow, ice, nothing is observed here in this range. You can observe clearly the road. Very much thanks to BRO, that is Border Road Organization, as they have maintained very good road here. And the gradient, that means slope of road maintained, is very nice. And that's why no doubt we are at very high altitude. The beginning point is only above 3000 meter altitude, and we are crossing over nearly 5000 meter plus. So in that case, oxygen deficiency is there, and that's why you'll find that road is maintained in such a way that even engine of bike or any vehicle may not have much of the problem. Here some of the bikers are coming out. In our journey, we located them from long distance. You can check out now that valley that is almost at height of Leh, and from that we are climbing up slowly. The day when we traveled there at Khar Dung La, it was in month of August, but still opposite hills were having snow, the snow covered peaks. After interaction with these bikers, we realized that they have achieved, they summit that peak, and then on free day they came here to see Khar Dung La. Later on we got interaction with them. A person is walking, you can observe in that month of August they are carrying out marathon race at Khar Dung La. You can check out that other people are also walking there. I am at very high altitude and carrying out this recording, and therefore hand is not that shady, not steady. Shaking is somewhat observed here. Now here intentionally I kept voice, so you can hear the voice of all these bikes. You are aware that sound waves are going in upward direction very easily. That's why we are able to hear that voice. Many times we have this type of hairpin shaped bends. See that marathon racer that is walking. Now roads are such broad that easily vehicles can pass out. Earlier days it was not, but now there is broadening in road. Later on we realize that these bikers are also from Maharashtra. That's why you can hear voice from one of the person at Jai Maharashtra. I am carrying out this recording with some handy camera. They were hired bikes. We have traveled from Maharashtra with ordinary bikes. By seeing that number plate, they shouted Jai Maharashtra. This is called as South Pulu part, where we had to give our documents, verify document, and then proceed for further journey. There is checkpost of army. A permit we had to take from Leh. Offices are there where we had to pay some amount and take permit. So we are at that South Pulu. This is my ordinary bike, as I say, that it is Honda Livo bike, 110cc only. And with all my, whatever the material, inclusive air pump and all that, we traveled here, obviously single seat. So we were only three people. Road condition till South Pulu was very good, as you observed. South Pulu onwards, work was going on. What's going on means we visited this place in month of August 2018. So at that time work was in progress. Maybe possible right now when you observe this video, that work must have finished also. Now here we'll find that no trees are there. This is all cold desert. No doubt road is not tar road, but maintained nicely as compared to world's highest road. And also we observed that work in progress. So maybe possible within year or 2 years that may be covered by tar. Very nice motorable road. We can check out the way we came up. At extreme end, downside, we can see the Leh. Again, we are observing these snow-covered peaks. Again and again, I am focusing on that. Very nice blue-colored sky. I have intentionally taken various halts. Some 3 to 4 halts I have taken for recording also, and let my engine get cold. So it was month of August, so temperature was not that low. Still, on certain peaks near Khar Dung, ice is there. Little bit cloudy conditions are there. We can observe various glaciers. And in month of August, the biggest problem in traveling is only whatever the water is coming out from that glacier. Sometimes we have to cross that water. And then we have to cross it before 11 a.m. Then only we can get easy pass. Otherwise it's a bit difficult because water level rises after 11 a.m. because glaciers are melting out and water level rises. Now here we can check out the broad road is there, and now we approach Khar Dung. Height is mentioned here 17,000 plus feet. Now here we can say that people are there. They are taking out bicycles. This service is also available in Leh, that we can take out bicycles over there and then descend down some 55 kilometer. We can take enjoyment without voice of engine. We can go there. This is all the Khar Dung, where North Pulu is a 14 kilometer and we are there at 18,380 feet. Whereas here board shows 17,980 feet. So like that, some errors in boards placed by same organization, they are there. Children are also coming out here. And security people are also present here.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. What is your experience here?
Main abhi aaya hoon, sir. Main bhi tourist leke aaya hoon.
Abhi tourist leke aaya hai?
Guest leke aaya sir.
Kahan se tourist leke aaya?
Yahan le.
Okay.
Guest sir. Apna.
Aap hamesha aate ho yahan pe?
Nahi sir. Abhi guest leke aaya.
Okay. Very nice. Sir.
Kahan jaao sir?
Nubra Valley.
Okay. 100 km. Kuch 60 km.
The towers and all cold desert. They say that you should not wait here for more than half an hour. This is my friend Milind Bhosle. Finally, we achieved the target of Khar Dung. Actually, some task was there that I wanted to complete this target by my 110cc bike. Now, the videography is carrying out by Milind Bhosle. With his inspiration, I was able to carry out this task till here successfully. Yeah, little bit pickup problem is there. It's there. I'm not saying that, okay, it is going easily. Little bit pickup problem is there. Okay.
What is your experience about this Khar Dung?
Very nice experience. Your confidence level is important. Okay. That altitude syndrome and all these things, they are also there. I'm not saying that no altitude syndrome is there. But your confidence level is playing important role. So if you have confidence, so there are people that are driving here by bicycle. They are coming here by marathon, running. So what is hard in that? So you can also come by this type of vehicle. No, and all vehicles, you can check out now, that all vehicles are coming out here. So it is not that the road is that hard. Our army maintained this road very nicely. You can consider that at such high altitude also, motorable road is there.
say we can say tar and all that, but otherwise road is very nice.
But we should say thanks to BRO.
Yeah, we have to give great thanks to BRO, because of BRO only we can achieve this target here. So once again, thanks to BRO, and as well as thanks to my Honda Livo bike. Thanks to Milin Bhosle also.
Thanks, Mahesh.
Some photography we carried out there. That is an evidence that we went there. For that purpose, now selfies are required more. This is very good road condition. Now we are descending out to other side of Khar Dung. So that is Khar Dung from north side. Now in this valley, we can observe rainfall. I carried out some photography from distance of this. All this is Karakorum range, that is Trans-Himalayan range. And from distance, we observed this rainfall in valley. The name of river here is Shok River. Another river is coming out. There is confluence of two rivers. That name is Nubra River. So we call this as Nubra Valley, which leads to Siachen Glacier. Now we are approaching towards this Siachen Glacier. With these photographs, you can check out the altitude at which we are here. Already we have descended from Khar Dung to very great depth, but still we can check out this mountainous part. And through this valley, see, this is now best part of this valley where Shok River is flowing out. Here the rivers are not flowing in one direction, they are continuously changing out their path. Whatever you are observing here is water of that river, and in that basin only some village is situated, which is having very nice greenery around it. Otherwise all area is something like desert. These are the junctions. Boards are maintained by BRO, because here no mobile network is there. Only BSNL service is working, but at certain places only. This is the Shok River. See the marvelous road just turning around the river. These are certain peaks, yet little bit snow is there on the peak. Dry glacier, whereas this is all Shok River having very nice water stream. This all we are carrying out recording somewhere around 4 o'clock evening. So you can check out the rise in water level. And here you can check out the road condition and the depth of valley. Because of this glacier and water, mountain ranges are cut very nicely here. The sharp edges that we are not able to enter easily in the water, whereas this is the height, we can check out a sharp edge. This is all cold desert of Karakoram range or Trans-Himalayan range. Shok is tributary of river Indus, and this is all a recording of myself in my helmet only. I'm trying to shoot myself in this desert. Thanks for observing this video.